On the ice right now is Gary Beacom. Gary Beacom is a young man who's in his fourth year, a physics major. He's between his compulsory figures. He was reading such thick physics books on something about the curvature of the earth. And here he is. He's his own coach, and he's certainly his own man. You never know what he's going to deliver. You never know what he's going to come up with, except that you know it's going to be very exciting and entertaining. 23-year-old Gary Beacom from the Toronto Cricket Club.
And he's going to start the program the same way Brian Orser started his program, with the triple Lutz jump. He's just warming up here with a few unique moves and edges. And he'll gather some speed and come around at this end of the ice for the triple Lutz.
That's the way Orser usually does it. And it's always great to see somebody coming along to challenge the champion, and even upsets from time to time are good. The only problem with it is when your champion is defeated and goes to the Olympics or the World, those European judges figure, what happened to him at home?
Skater, watch this combination coming up, combination of jumps right into a nice double flip jump.
Gary's moves are so unique that it's hard to get to the rest of the judges in the world to accept them for their true value. It was very much in the way that Trawler Cranston had difficulty making them accept them.
And you know, we always talk about Gary's unique style, and it is unique and wonderful, but his jumps are the things that have improved the most over the last year. The technique and the double axel and all the triple jumps has very much improved.
One of those triple jumps coming up. That's it, triple Salchow. He really had to hang on in that landing edge, and he did.
Well, he pulled out of the first one ahead of that early, and maybe he was shaky in that whole section.
Jumps right over the board. Second one, way high. Triple flip.
There
jump.
Goes the triple flip.
Put his hand down. Look at these moves.
He gets going so well, and all of a sudden he hits a jackpot like that, just as he did in the Worlds last year, where he suddenly dropped the 13th. It's better than that.
Difficult entry into that double axel. He stayed backward, turned a bracket, and then into the double axel. And a great variation of a layout spin.
He's going wild out there, and so's the crowd.
Those are Beacom moves. Yeah. runs that I said earlier, the judges find highly appreciated.
Watch this set.
It's a standing ovation here in Regina.
Gary Beacom.
Well, I don't know about you, Otto, but I'm not even going to venture to guess what's going to happen today. We'll just have to wait for those marks, and I'll tell you, I would not want to be a judge.
The problem is, as Johnny pointed out, if Gary Beacom beats Brian Orchard here, Brian will be going to the Olympics not as a current Canadian champion, and that may hurt Brian's chances in Sarajevo next month. But here tonight, this championship, Gary, in my opinion, skated better than Brian Orchard.
And the judges should mark the performance they see tonight. They shouldn't go on past performances. And watch this triple Lutz. Has a very good takeoff, nice tight position in the air, and a nice quick landing, and right into that landing position, very solid, and a great way to start that program.
That was one of his best jumps. He went from then on in to retro, saw the unique moves, but certainly his spins, as we're seeing now, it's terrific. And now here's flashed up his first set of marks.
These marks were technical merit, 5-7, 2-5-6s, 5-7, 2-5-6s, and a 5-7. Now the judges have marked him low in the eyes of the audience, but at least they've marked him very consistently. Now the marks for a presentation, 2-5-8s, 5-9, 5-8, 5-7, 5-8, and a 5-7. It's going to take some time before you can get the flowers all off the ice. We can tell you that Brian Orser has moved ahead of Gary Beacom. Brian Orser has moved ahead of Gary Beacom with all the permutations and combinations of those judges' marks. Orser has retained his title, unless, of course, he loses it to Forbes. And I think the odds of that happening are remote. I think that it's a mathematical possibility, but I think it is extremely remote. But